Good evening, welcome to the Daily Office, and thank you for joining me. This is Night Prayer for Friday, October 24th. It's the 19th week after Pentecost and week 2 in the Psalm cycle. And the scripture for this service, Psalm 31, verse 1 through 8, and Revelation chapter 9, verse 13 to 21. And please join me in singing verse 6 of Psalm 100 by Isaac Watts to the tune of Old 100. Wide as the world is your command, vast as eternity your love, firm as a rock your truth must stand. When rolling years shall see to move. Our help is in the name of God Most High, the Maker of heaven and earth. Let us confess our sins to God. Together, O merciful God, we have sinned through our own fault, in our thoughts and words and deeds, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. We beseech you, overlook our faults and cast our sins behind your back, that we may serve you and praise you all the days of our lives. Amen. And may Almighty and merciful God grant us forgiveness of all our sins and the grace and the comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, come to my assistance, make haste to help me. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Alleluia, in you I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Alleluia, Psalm 31. And please recite together with me. Alleluia. In you I put my trust, let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in your righteousness. Bend your ear to me, deliver me speedily. Be my strong rock, a castle to save me. For you are my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net that they have laid for me, for you are my strength. Into your hands I commit my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O God of truth. I have hated them that regard worthless idols, but I trust in you. I will be glad and rejoice in your love, for you have considered my trouble. You have known my soul in distress. You have not shut me up into the hand of the enemy. You have set my feet in a large, open place. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. In you I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Alleluia. A lesson from the Revelation to John, chapter 9, beginning at verse 13. And then the sixth angel blew his trumpet, and I heard a voice from the four horns of the golden altar before God, saying to the sixth angel who had the trumpet, "Release the four angels who are bound at the great river Euphrates." And so the four angels were released, who had been held ready for the hour, the day, the month, and the year to kill a third of humankind. The number of the troops of cavalry was 200 million. I heard their number, and this was how I saw the horses in my vision. The riders wore breastplates, the color of fire and of sapphire and of sulfur. And the heads of the horses were like lions' heads, and fire and smoke and sulfur came out of their mouths. And by these three plagues, a third of humankind was killed by the fire and smoke and sulfur coming out of their mouths. For the power of the horses is in their mouths and in their tails. Their tails are like serpents, having heads, and with them they inflict harm. The rest of humankind, who were not killed by these plagues, did not repent of the works of their hands, or give up worshiping demons and idols of gold and silver and bronze and stone and wood, which cannot see or hear or talk. And they did not repent of their murders, or their sorceries, or their fornications, or their thefts. Here ends the lesson. And now let us offer our prayers and petitions, and please respond, hear our prayer. We thank you for bringing us safely to the end of this day, and we thank you for all the blessings that you have granted us. O God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the Mercy of God community, for brothers Joe, Ronald Francis, Alan, Thomas, Todd Dunstan, William Paul, Raymond Patrick, Richard Robert, Max Bartholomew, William John, and Donald Columba. For all who seek you, tender God, that they may find and be found. O God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That your will may be done in all that we undertake, to the benefit of ourselves and our families and friends, the church, and all people. O God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of Francis and Claire and all your saints, let us commend one another and all of our lives to Christ our God. O God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the intentions of those who've asked our prayers, and for all of your intentions. O God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Together. Our beloved, which art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive others. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Let us pray. Lead us and guide us, and take us out of the net that the wicked have set for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Alleluia, O tender God, you have seduced me, and I was seduced. Alleluia. And may the Almighty and Merciful God, the source of all being, eternal Word, and Holy Spirit, bless us and keep us now and forever. Amen. Alleluia.